In this video, I want to go over a music player called Noise Music Player. Now, the Noise Music Player is also referred to as Music. It is the default music player for Elementary OS, and if you found this video on YouTube, I will provide a link below the video that will give you a definition, how to install it, and how to use the program. Now, as I already mentioned, the Noise Music Player, also known as Music, is the default music player, audio player for Elementary OS. And I give you a little bit of background of it underneath the picture, and here's how to install it on your system. First, you open up your terminal. You copy this list of commands, which installs the PPA, to your system. So you just basically paste that into your terminal, press the enter or return key, put your password in, then update your system, and then you're going to copy and paste sudo apt install noise. Now, even though it's now called music, you still install it from the command noise. And you can see on Launchpad, if you want to install it by the installation file, the deb packages, you simply scroll down, choose the newest deb that matches your system. This was right here, like for the AMD 64-bit systems. If I wanted to install that, I would download this one, and it would pull in, as it installs, the dependencies that it needs. Now, if you click on the GitHub website, you'll see a little bit of the history. You can go back and install some of the older versions. As you can see, it used to be called Noise, in parentheses, Music, but then when it changed to version 5.0, it changed it. That dropped off the noise and just be called Music. But I do see on forums where people still call it Noise, and you install it by the command noise. So I'll still refer to it as the Noise Music Player. So I'm still including the word music within the name. If you later decide that you don't want it on your system, you just simply copy this sudo apt remove noise, and then don't forget to remove the PPA from your system by copying this and putting that in your terminal as well. Now, I'm using Ubuntu Mate 18.04.4, the long-term support, with a traditional menu. So I access it through the applications menu, sound and video, and then I click on music. Now, your icon may be different. It depends upon the theme that I'm currently using on this system. Now, as you can see here, when it first loads, and now when you see mine load in just a few moments, mine will have a lot of cover art. Yours may not have any cover art, depending upon if you've got music in the default music folder. If you've got it somewhere else, then you won't have any audio or music files. If you do have music in that current default music folder, you will have some songs or albums within your list when you first install it. If not, you can go click the settings, and I recommend going to the preferences first to set your default music folder, and then import your library if it's from another hard drive inside your machine or outside your machine. As you can see here, when it first loads, you'll see as it's loading, you'll have a progressive bar that will grow until it completes, and then you'll see all your list of songs in a list. You've got three views. You've got your cover art, your list, and your columns that you can view. Here is your toolbar. Your toolbar is made up of your title bar, the name of the song that's currently being played, a progression bar of the music. You've got a search feature. You can search for songs or albums. You got your settings that shows your import libraries or preferences. Then you got your back. You can move back a song, your play, forward, and then those are your covers, list, and columns. This is what it looks like when you choose to view your albums by cover. It will list all your cover art. The first time you're importing all of your libraries, it may be missing some cover art. I don't know where it gets it across the internet, so you may have to manually go and download them, and it will call the cover art cover. So in that music folder, it will put a file with the images called cover.jpg, and that way it will place the cover art image on this little square block. In a few moments, I'll show you how to fix that if you've got an empty block here to represent the cover art. Now, here is, that was the cover. If you want to see the cover view, this is the list view, which has your title, length, artist, album, and genre. The next one is your column view, which lists your genre, artist, albums, and basically like a small list view that lists the songs of your current selections at the top. Now, when you click the settings menu, when you click preferences, it brings up a preference dialog box, and it has the default music folder. You can click the drop down and change that to whatever folder or the location that you have your music. You've got some management buttons that you can change. If you like to play the music in the background when you hit the close button, you can turn this feature on to continue playback when closed. If you like to hit close button and it closes out, then turn this feature off. Now at the bottom you see here, you've got an equalizer and you can add new playlists. You can create your own set of playlists here according to genre or whatever playlist you want to create. And then you can create a smart playlist where you can say that certain criteria has to be met in order to go in that playlist that you create as a smart playlist. And I show you here on the website how to create those playlists and how to create a smart playlist. I show you how you can access and turn on the equalizer. And then down here, I show you how, if you have some missing cover art, how you can go in here and when you click on the name of the album or you click on the album itself, you click on the cover art, it will come up with a little dialog box saying set new album cover. Once that you've located the album cover, put it into that folder and call it cover.jpg. You click on that, it will replace with it where it says Dina Carter and there's no album, it will put a cover art into that folder. Now sometimes you may get cover art that is not correctly sized. These are squares, which means the size of them has to be square. So originally the Dina Carter album that I originally found across the internet wasn't completely square. It was longer than it was tall. So I had to make the width and the height the same size, which is 500 by 500. So I chose by absolute rate and I unchecked this feature, and this is within Penta. You don't have to use Penta, you can use any other image editor that lets you change the size, like GTHumb or any other type of program. And once that you save it, as you can see here, I made them both 500 by 500 making it square, then I hit the OK, and then I reloaded the image art and it filled up the complete box. So if you have some that loads and they're not the right size, you can fix it with an image editor that you can resize. Now I already have the music player loaded. If I close it out and come up here, or I can go through my menu and I click on music, and it takes a few seconds to load because it pulls all the songs and all the cover art, because the cover art, remember, is a file stored on your system. Now this is a very basic music player. There's not a lot of features to it. It doesn't have things to where I can edit this and do a lot of editing to songs. I can edit my playlist, but there's not a lot of features other than playing the music that it's found. You can change the views, the cover art view, the list view, and the column view. And then across the top you've got the progressive bar. So when you choose an album, let's say for example I click on this one, if I wanted a song to play, and I'm not going to, I could double click this and it would start playing the song. The song would be moving across, as you can see here, this little bubble or circle would move across the progressive bar showing you where it's currently at in the song. Now it does have a button here that you can click to shuffle the song so they're not played in that particular order. And it also has, so if you want to play this album over and over, you can click this button and it will enable repeat so that when it's finished it'll start back that album again. You can search for a song or an album with a search feature, or you can click on your import library or your preferences. And when you first install that, if you have no music here, go to your preferences, change this to where your music folder is at that contains all of your music or albums. You can turn on whatever management feature that you like, and if you say continue playback when it's closed, when you close this feature it'll continue playing. I don't like it when I close it. If I want to listen to music in the background, I can minimize it, but if you do like to close it and don't have something minimized on your taskbar, you can turn that on so when you close it it'll stay up here but it will still be playing in the background. So those are all the preferences. There's not a lot of preferences that you have on tweaking or customizing this particular program. It's very basic, but some people, including myself, love those basic players. As you can see here, you've got to where you can move back to the previous song. So if you were here, you hit previous, it'll go back a song. Here's your play feature, so I can click on it one time, click the play button, or I can double click, and that starts to play. After I hit play, that changes to the pause button, so it's the play's pause button. This advances you to the next track. So if you're playing an album and there's a song you just don't care for, then you can hit forward and it, or next, and it goes to your next song. These are your albums, your list, and your columns view, which I've already showed. Here is your library, and you can add additional libraries, and you can add more playlists. You can click the playlist button, add a playlist, and it comes up here, and you can title it whatever you want, and then you can put songs to those, and it gives you a description here. Now, if you wanted to remove a playlist, you right-click on it, allows you to rename a playlist, remove a playlist, or export a playlist from some other location. So in this case, I don't want a new playlist, I can hit remove. Now if I wanted a smart playlist, I could say add a smart playlist, click on this, and I could name it just like you see the name here, and I could set up rules. I could say match any or all of the following. If it come from a particular, if an album is blank, say remove it from the list. Or you can add things, you can change it for an album, you can say if it's artist, bitrate, you can choose a lot of things. You can say is, you can say contains or does not contain, you can set the rules, and you can set how many songs can be added to this playlist that's your smart playlist. By default, it's currently set at 50 songs added to your smart playlist. You can uncheck that and it won't be a limit, or you can change the limit by moving up or down or manually typing it in. So you can create your own smart playlist. Now let me go back to the cover art. Let me choose this feature. Well, let me get off the playlist and go back to my music. Click on my cover art. Let me scroll down to where I see 504. Here it is. As you can see here, I deliberately left one that has a white line below it, where it's not completely square. So you can see this one's not either. And sometimes it will pull them in and there'll be a small thumbnail within this square box. That means it's too small. You have to resize it or find one larger to put in there. So you click on here. As you can see here, that is too small. So I need to go into this folder and make that a square, and then I can click on it and select the new album that I've made adjustments to or where I placed it. So as you can see here, that's the 504 Boys Goodfellas album. So I've already got it here. And when I double click onto it, as you can see here in the lower right hand corner, it's 160 by 156. It's not completely square. And because it's not completely square, that's the reason why that you see the white line across the bottom. So to fix that, it's easy. You right click, use any image editor. I like Penta. I do most of my graphic arts from my webpage using Penta. So I can go to image, resize the image. I want to say absolute value. I don't want to keep the aspect ratio. So I can say either 156 by 156, or I can change this one, say 160. I normally don't recommend, if you got a small file, increasing it very large or to make it blurry, but that's not much of a change. So when I hit OK, that makes it square. So I hit the Save button. I want to hit OK. Now that image is now square. So when I double click onto it, instead of saying 160 by 156, it's now 160 by 160, which is a square image. So I now go back to my music player. It hasn't updated yet, so I go to Set New Album Cover. I go to the location where it's at. I go to my music at the top. I choose the cover image, hit open, and it now has fixed where it's not the correct size. So if when you install it there's missing albums, go out and look for the albums that it's missing, and if they're too small, just use your editor and make them square. So this is a great music player. I'm not going to play any songs because I don't want to get any copyright violations, but it's a very basic player. So if you decide to use it, overlook the fact that it has trouble with some album art, or I'm not saying overlook it. Once that you get your album art on to your system, you know, it may be a little time consuming the first time you install it, but after that it's a great program. It plays music just like it's supposed to, and the album art is very nicely organized. It's easy to find your albums by scrolling up and down, locating your albums, click onto a particular album and choose a particular song and start playing. The only disadvantage other than the album art has trouble with it is there's no volume control. You have to use your master volume control for the actual volume of this player. But other than that, it is a great music player. So if you've not ever heard of the Noise Music Player or the Music Player, please give it a try, and hopefully this video has been helpful to you, and have a great day.